afternoon to Swaros. First of all, my name is M. Premalatha from TTWRDC, Devarakonda, degree second year BSc MPCS group. First of all, I heartfully thankful to you, our beloved dynamic secretary, Dr. R.S. Praveen Kumar sir, to provide this opportunity to me. Sir, I feel proud to be a Swara. I can teach thee in live classes. And also one thing, sir, I am studying in this institution. I can learn more and more from this institution. What I am learning, it is a very useful in my life. And also, sir, you can provide a lot of programs, but we are learning not from the study. And also, we are learning every activity and we are participating in every program. It is a very, very important to every student. And also, sir, and we can follow our rules and regulations in our society, means our Gurukulam society. And also, we can follow our 10 commandments. That is the main aim of our Swaros. So, heartfully thankful to you, sir, to given this golden opportunity to me. I am now here by the purpose of only you. A good student made by a good teacher. So, heartfully thankful to you, sir, to given this golden opportunity to me. Okay, Swaros, let's come to our topic. Today, our subject is computer science. First of all, whenever we are entering into the subject, means topic, I say one thing. So, what is our country? Our country is India. But our country is a developing country or developed country? Yes, our country is only developing country, not developed country. But comparing to other countries and any other etc. countries, we can identify some countries are already developed countries and some countries are only developing countries. Including these countries, our country can also be only developing country, not developed country. But what way we are and why we are using to and what way we are to develop our country? By using the technology. We have to develop a lot of technologies and we can use to develop our India. But this technology is coming from the, what way this technology coming from? Computers. But first of all, we know about the what is computer and how many generations of computers we have and we know that. Okay, friends, first of all, we know the total about the computers and how many computer generation system we have. Now onwards, we are staying in the fifth generation of computers. Before going the topic, we know totally about the how many generations of computer systems. First generation of computer system can be started in 1940 to 1956. We can start the first generation of computers. These first generation of computers, we can use the vacuum tubes. It is a large and expansive. These vacuum tubes consist of a glass bulb and a wire. This wire is carried to data in the form of electrical signals. And also, friends, this fifth generation of computers, we are using a vacuum tube. It is a large computer system. It can be maintained by at least 3 or 4 members. And also, friends, we can say that ENIAC, the abbreviation of this ENIAC means Electronical Numerical Integrated and Calculator is the first generation of computers. And next we go to step second is the second generation of computer. The second generation of computers we can use in the period of 1956 to 1963. That is the transistor. This transistor also same like a large and expansive comparing to first generation of computers. The second generation of computers we can the transistor instead of vacuum tubes. And next third step is a third generation of computers. These third generation of computers we can use the integrated circuit. This integrated circuit is smaller than the second generation of computer, that is the transistor. Okay, friends, before and we can say about the third generation of computers. This third generation of computers can be started in the period of 1960 through to 1971. What is the period of third generation of computer is 1963 to 1971. We can use the third generation of computers. And next, fourth generation of computers. We know that, friends, now we are using a lot of microprocessor. That is the fourth generation of computers. We can use the fourth generation of computers in the period of 1971 to present. Means we are using now onwards microprocessor. So many states and so many countries are so many members are they can use the microprocessor. Now onwards also we can use the these microprocessor. Okay friends, this microprocessor is smaller than the comparing to first generation of computers and second generation of computer, that is the vacuum tubes and the transistor. This microprocessor is a consist of silicon chip on which thousands of circuits are placed. And okay friends, this fourth generation of computer is cheaper and portable and smaller than the second generation of computers and the first generation of computer. And the next one is the fifth generation of computers. Where we are now here, we are now in the present of fifth generation of computers. The fifth generation of computer is the most advanced computer. That is the AI. What is the abbreviation of AI? Artificial intelligence. We know today our topic is artificial intelligence. Before going the topic artificial intelligence, Pharos, we know totally about the what is meant by intelligence and what is meant by artificial intelligence. Before going this topic, we know about the what is meant by intelligence. Okay friends, but this AI is a broad classification about the artificial intelligence. This class is a very very important to now this generation and before future also. This generation is a very fast, we are using the more and more artificial intelligence. But friends, we are know totally about the what is meant by intelligence. Intelligence is a nothing but the capacity to learn and solve the problems. What is the meaning of intelligence? The capacity to learn and solve the problems in a particular way. And also the ability to take action, have an effort. And the ability to take solve novel problems. The ability to act rationally. The ability to act like a human. Okay friends, the intelligence is nothing but the ability to interact with the real world. Okay friends, and also but we are passive, understand and act. First of all, we clearly to see the definition of what is intelligence. Okay friends, but this artificial intelligence, we have some outlines. So what are they? What is AI? History of AI? Application of AI? Robots? Types of robots? Advantages? Disadvantages? Future of AI and conclusion. Okay friends, but we know what is meant by intelligence. To respond to situation very flexibly, to make sense out of ambiguous or contradictory messages, to recognize relative importance of different elements of situation, to find similarities between the situations and situation despite difference, to draw distinction between the situations, disputes, similarities which link them. Okay friends, this is about the intelligence. But this intelligence, we have two main concepts are there. One is the reasoning and planning and another one is the learning and adapting. Means friends, first one is the reasoning and planning. These reasoning and planning, modeling the external world given a input, solving new problems, planning and make decision, ability to take action, have an effort, ability to take deal with the unexpected problems and uncertainty. And this is the reasoning and planning. And second one is the learning and adaptation. What is meant by learning and adaptation? We are continuously learning and adapting. Our internal models are always being updating. This is about the intelligence, friends. Okay, but these intelligence can be divided into two parts. One is a natural intelligence and another one is the artificial intelligence. But what is meant by natural intelligence and what is meant by artificial intelligence? Before going to artificial intelligence, we know about the what is natural intelligence. Natural intelligence is a nothing but it is a man creation, means human being creation. A God can give gift to us to live on the earth. We are the human beings. We are living on the earth. This is the natural intelligence. We have to capacity to solve every problem in anywhere. It is a dangerous or it is critical or it is a flexibly. We are solving every problem. But we are a human beings. We have capacity to solve every problem. A God can give facility to solve any problem. This is the natural intelligence. But before going to artificial intelligence, I can say one thing, that is a God creation we are staying here. By a human being creation, a robots are here. That is the main aim of artificial intelligence. Are you understand this, friend? Artificial intelligence is nothing but robots. This robot is the one type of the artificial intelligence. This artificial intelligence is AI is a branch of computer science that study a computational requirement for tasks such as perception, reasoning and learning and develop systems to perform those tasks. The field of artificial intelligence strives to understand and build intelligent entities. Okay, these artificial intelligence can be divided into two parts. One is a strong AI and another one is a weak AI. Okay, friends, we know that what is the mean by artificial intelligence. Artificial intelligence is nothing but it is a machine. It is a branch of computer science. AI have a capacity to solve any problem and to create the and to modify to the world in a future, means a flexible way. This is the aim of artificial intelligence. But artificial intelligence is a manipulation of human intelligence processor by machines, especially that is a computer science. So friends, the aim of AI is to learning, to reasoning and to self-correction, means it have a capacity to deal with everything by has. Without the help of human beings, a artificial intelligence can have no capacity to solve any problem. That is the main aim of AI. Okay, friends, now we know that what is artificial intelligence and what is natural intelligence and what is intelligence. But this artificial intelligence have some history. That is the early beginning in 1943, M.C. Kuloz and Pitts. Her scientist name is M.C. Kuloz and Pitts. He can research about the Boolean circuit model of brain. And 1950, Turing, computing machines and intelligence. In 1956, Dartmouth conference. And this is the history of artificial intelligence. But early beginning in 1943, M.C. Kuloz and Pitts to research about the to modeling the brain, means to difference between the computer version and a human being version, means a computer have a how much capacity to do work and a human beings have how much capacity to do work, means the difference between the brain of a computer system and a human beings. So in this way, our M.C. Kuloz and Pitts scientists research about the early beginning of the modeling the brain of in a Boolean way, means a true or false. A machine have, means a computer system is a machine. That machine have capacity to solve any problem or it is a true or false. This is research about the 1943. Okay, friends, in 1950, Turing, means computing the external intelligence in the machine, means to put the intelligence in the machine. That can be done, that can be work like a artificial intelligence, means robots. Okay, friends, in 1956, birth of AI. In 1943 to 1956, to birth of AI, that is the artificial intelligence. The father of AI is John McCarthy. In 1956, he can identify that a machine have capacity to solve any problems, it is difficult or dangerous, it flexibly to solve the any problems. That is the birth of AI in 1956. In 1955 to 65, initial promise means AI include programs and check programs. These AI have also to wrote the programs. These programs are done by the only human beings. Okay, friends, and 1955 to 65, a great enthusiasm means AI have a capacity to solve any problem. And also 1966 to 1973, 1969 to 1984 and 1985, rise of machine learning. In 1985, a scientist can research about the a machine have capacity to solve any problems. They can research in the year of 1956. And also in 1950, role of uncertainty, and 1995 to present onwards 2019, AI is a science. It is a branch of computer science. Means a scientist can research about the AI is a nothing but any critical or dangerous problems. This can be done by the only artificial intelligence. Artificial intelligence have capacity to solve a novel problems. But without the guidance of the human beings, AI have no capacity to solve any problems. Okay, friends, this is a large and a critical and history of the AI. But we have some applications about the AI. So, okay, friends, this is a major component of AI. We have four major components that is also applications of the AI. First one is the expert system, and second one is the natural language processing, and third one is the speech recognition, and fourth one is the computer vision. Okay, friends, first one is the expert system. Expert system is nothing but an expert system is a computer program designed to act as an expert in a particular domain's area of expertise. Means a process in an expert system. Expert system currently are designed to assist expert, not to replace them. They have been used in a medical diagnosis, chemical analysis, geological explanation, etc. Okay, friends, this is about the expert system. Expert system is nothing but a computer program designer that can be done by the in an active manner, and expert system, what is going on there? This computer program can be designed in an expert system. But these expert system can use the three most popular ways, that is the medical diagnosis, and the second one is the chemical analysis, and the third one is geological exploration. This is about the expert system, and the second one is a natural language processing. The goal of AI is to enable people and computers to communicate in a natural, humanly language, that is the English rather than the computer language. The field of AI is divided into two categories. One is a natural language understanding, and second one is a natural language generation. Okay, friends, this is about the natural language processing. This natural language processing is nothing but AI is to enable people to understand the language of computer system. This computer system can understand only English language rather than the computer language. And also the field of AI is divided into two parts, means two categories. That is, first one is natural language understanding, and the second one is natural understanding generation. This is a very, very important to AI. Means AI is nothing but machine. Machine have capacity to understand what is what is going on there. And it can only, computer system can only understand the English language rather than the computer language. Okay, friends. And third one is a computer vision. Means, and also fourth one is a speech recognition. And speech recognition. Speech recognition is nothing but the primary interactive method of communication used by humans. Is not reading and writing, it is a speech. The goal of speech recognition research is to allow computers to understand human speech so that they can hear our voices and recognize the words we are speaking. It simplifies the process of interactive communication between people and computers. Thus, it advances the goal of NLP, means natural language processing. This speech recognition is a very, very important to AI. Because of we are going to AI, AI have some capacity to understand this speech recognition. But it cannot be completely understand what is human being thinking. But it can only understand the singular words from the small vocabulary. It is the percentage of only 99% they can understand the speech recognition of human beings. That is the computer system aim. And also one thing, friends, a machine can understand and to everything about the human beings, what they are talking. But before going to, they are understanding the human being voice, but it can understand and it can do everything. But a normal speech is a much more dangerous to a computer. Means a computer have no capacity to understand everything, but it can identify and it can recognize a singular words from this small vocabulary in 60 to 70%. Only that's enough a machine have capacity to recognize the speech recognition. Okay, friends, and fourth one is a computer vision. Computer vision. People generally use vision as their primary mean of sensing their environment. We generally see more than we hear, feel or smell or taste. The goal of computer vision research is to give computers this same powerful faculty for understanding their surroundings. Here, AI help computer to understand what they see through attached cameras. Okay, friends, we know what we are reading now. A computer vision have a capacity to understand what is going on their surroundings. Means we are a human beings. We have a facility to see and observe it is what is going on the earth. But what is behind you? But it is a only God gift. But a God creation, we are living in the earth. We have a facility to understand whatever may be and what is going on behind you. But this is AI is a artificial intelligence, means it have a no capacity. But some ways, this artificial intelligence have a capacity to understand what is going on behind you. Means, friends, these artificial intelligence have capacity to understand what is going on the earth. And also, without using the attached cameras, they have no capacity to understand and seeing and hearing whatever may be what is behind you. Means, a machine have capacity only to observe and recognize single words, what is going on there. That is the aim of machine. And also, friends, a computer have a capacity to see whatever may be what is going on the earth, and that is the by only human being creation. Without the guidance of human being, means without putting the any cameras to the one machine, that machine have a no capacity to see and observe our earth. Means this is the computer vision. Okay, friends, before going to artificial intelligence, I can say what is meant by artificial intelligence. Artificial AI is nothing but robots. But we know what is robot. Robotics. The robot is an electromechanical device that can perform manual tasks, are reprogrammable, multifunctional manipulator designed to move materials, parts, tools are specialized devices through variable programmed motions for a performance of variety of tasks. And also one thing, an intelligence robots include some kinds of sensory operators that is that allow it to respond to change in its environment. Friends, robotic is nothing but electromechanical devices. Sir, no? Yes, everyone know. I think everyone know what is robot. It is an electromechanical device that can perform device that can perform a manual task. Means a robot can have capacity to solve any problem, any critical dangerous problem that robot have capacity. Without the help of human beings, a robot can have not solve any problem in the world. Robot is a nothing but artificial intelligence. Robot is a one part of artificial intelligence, but not totally about the artificial intelligence. Okay, friends, these robots have a capacity to solve everything. These robots have some sensory apparatus that can allow to use to understand what is going on the surroundings. That is the main aim of robots. And also, friends, these robots have a capacity and these robots have to utilize their battery, means machine. A human being to put the battery in her body means robot. These robots to take energy from battery and to solve to doing work in the all. Means without the help of human beings, a robot have a cannot do any work. Means really a robot is not intelligence, but it could be manual tasking to perform any work in the earth. And these robots are, we have a different types of robots. I think as far as everyone know the about the robot. And we also see the Robo movie and 2.0 movie and 1.0 movie. I think everyone know about the robot. But we have a lot of robots and these robots are to design a different ways. Okay friends, we can see first one. Okay, we have some types of robots. We have some types of robots, but these robots, first of all, we know in Robo movie, we can see Chitti Robo, yes or no? But in our world, everyone, somebody to make a robot, but nobody can give a robot names. But everyone call it as a robot, but nobody can give a robot one name. But country Saudi Arabia can use the robot and to give a name to one robot, that is the Sophia robot. This Sophia robot is look like a human being, means a female, a woman, look like a same as is a woman. This Sophia robots to take a charging in a battery. This Sophia look like a same, a female. The robot have eyes, face, teeth, lips, everything. But that Sophia robo have a capacity to do work anything. But somebody interact with the Sophia, take a interview about her. Somebody ask, Sophia, are you feel very happy to in this world? Yes, I feel very happy because of I am also living in the earth. That's why that robo Sophia can feel a very very happy by the creation of only human beings. A God can create us, we are to create a robot, that is the Sophia robot. But Sophia robot can have capacity to sing, to dance, everything. But some robots have no capacity to run in a fastly. Means this Sophia robot can only to walk in a slow, but don't run. This Sophia robot to interview, to take and to give speech, to sing a song, to dance, everything this Sophia robot can be do. But somebody ask, Sophia, are you destroy the human beings? No, I don't destroy the human beings because of that her creation. I am here, I am living a part of human beings. That's why I feel very happy to live on the earth, but I didn't destroy the human beings. But Sophia, one thing I can ask you. Sophia, are you female and male? I feel female, but Sophia can to give answer. A robot have a no gender, but I feel like a female, but not male. But whatever may be, I feel a female, but not male. A robots have a no gender. And also friends, somebody ask Sophia, I think you save me. Yes, I can serve in any places. I can help us human beings because of they are give a life. They can give a birth to me. I am living here. I am happy to stay here by the purpose of only human beings. That's why I salute heartfully to the human beings because of they can create me. I am living in the earth. And also somebody. Friends, we know that Chitty Robo in the movie of Robo, this Chitty Robo, what they do? The Chitty Robo can have a capacity like a same Sophia Robo, but this Chitty Robo can have a capacity to solve any problems. Friends, we know that a Chitty Robo can save a woman in the movie, and also friends, in that movie, Rajinikanth is a hero. Yes or no, friends? I think everyone know. In that movie, Rajinikanth is a hero. That hero can make a one robo, that is a Chitty Robo. And also, before the Chitty Robo, he can make a one robo. That robo can, once upon a time, to shake out the one building. That's why a government can order to don't use these robots. These robots are very dangerous to us. That government can give order to a people. But on that time, our hero Rajinikanth can take the Chitty Robo. That Chitty Robo have a no capacity to feel there what is in her. Means a robo have a no feelings and no emotions. Yes, sir, friends. That is a only artificial intelligence, means it is a only artificial, not a natural. That's why that robo have a no, not emotionals and feelings. On that time, that robo can save one woman, and any personal way that robo can to put that woman in the surroundings. On that time, there is a lot of members. And that woman can be died on that movie. Yes or no? Yes. In this way, the robo cannot have capacity. Means the robo have no feelings and emotional. What is going and whatever may be, that robo will be do work. That is a personal or that is a unpersonal or anything. But that robo can be do work on that way. But friends, these robots are do like this. On that time, Rajinikanth can to dismantle the totally Chitty Robo to put all the parts in the one side. But somebody to make a one robo and to give a charge to a negative charge means can to made a total robot in a negative charge means negative devices. That robo can totally collapse the earth means to destroy the everyone, to collapse the world, to collapse the all over the buildings. That way, that robots are very dangerous. And that time, Rajinikanth to once again remember to please to that robo, he can dismantle and put in inside and take a Chitty Robo and prepare once again that robo and give a battery to in this robo and this robo and also give a feelings and emotional. So, on that time, a Chitty Robo can do a work in a proper way. Means, on that time, a robot can get feelings and emotional. So, this is about the robot. Friends, we have a different types of robots, yes or no? But now onwards, we can see only Sophia Robo and Chitty Robo. But we have a different types of robots. So, let's come to see. we have a different types of robots. The most common types of robots are 5 types. That is a mobile robot, stationary robots, autonomous robots, remote controlled robots, and virtual robots. First one is the, what is the first one? Mobile robots. These mobile robots are very, very useful in our life. Means in this generation. Friends, we know that we are sending the satellites to the space. By what purpose we are sending the satellites? By a lot of purpose, means internet connection, and we are to send the satellites in the space to research there, and what is going on the another planets, to research the some scientists about that planets, about the that space. But somebody, human beings are going to the space, somebody will be came back, but somebody will be died on that place. Means it is a dangerous place, yes or no, friend? Yes, that's why a human being actually think to herself and to solve this problem only by the robots. Means a robots have a no die. Means a robots have a no, not have a capacity to die in that life. Means that robots have not die in her life. A robots are always do work in a night and a daytime. Okay, friends. These mobile robots are very useful to send the satellites to space. And what is going on there? These mobile robots are useful to research their space and research their surroundings. What is going on the planets and different planets? Our scientists are research about their what is going on the another planets. In that way, these mobile robots are we using. So, first one is the mobile robots. These mobile robots are divided into two parts. One is a rolling robot and another one is a walking robot. Friends, okay, mobile robot is divided into two parts. One is a rolling robot and another one is a walking robot. First one is a rolling robot. Yes or no, friend? Yes. This rolling robot is also same useful to send there in space and what is going on there in a different planets, to research their places. By this way, we can use the rolling robots. These robot can use a wheels in their legs. That is a rolling robot, friend. Are you see this picture? A first one is a rolling robot and second one is also same rolling robot. These rolling robots can use the wheels to move in a forward direction in a flat areas. But these rolling robots cannot move in a rocky places. Means it is a critical and a frictional places. That's why rolling robots are not moving in a critical places. But these rolling robots can go in space and to research the areas what is going on here. But these robots are to move in a flat areas by the using of wheels. Any more 4, 5, 6 any wheels their robo can use to move in a flat areas into the space. And next, second one is a friends, walking robots. This is the picture of walking robots. These walking robot have a capacity to move in a forward direction by using the 6 legs. At least this robo can use 4 legs, but this robo can use a 6 legs. And also we want to create another 2 legs also, friend. Okay, friend, this walking robot can use a 4 legs, but it cannot move in a flat areas. Means this walking robot can move in a, does not move in a flat areas. It can move in a only rock ways, means rock places. It is a lot of friction places. These walking robots can move in a forward direction in the space and to research the place what is going on the planets in the space. And second one is a friend, stationary robots. Please look at this picture. This is the stationary robot and second one is also stationary robots. But what purpose we are using the stationary robots? These stationary robots are we using the by the purpose of industry's purpose. Yes or no, friends? We know that what is industry and why we are using the stationary robots in the industries. industries have a lot of people are doing in their work. Means a lot of people are to do work in the factories. Yes or no? Yes. By doing this work, so many people are died in their machines by the doing work. Means industries have a critical problems is there. Yes or no? A critical problems to create and to solve by the people. On that time, so many people are died in their machines. So that our people, our world can thinking about a robot have a capacity to solve, to create anything in the industries. Means industry have a lot of problems to transfer goods from one place to another place. On that time, we have to send a people to transfer a goods from one place to another place. Another place. Friends, okay, this is about the stationary robots, but this is very, very useful in industry's purpose. And next one is the autonomous robots. These autonomous robots is very, very useful in our life. Means these autonomous robots are mainly useful in our surroundings. Means this robot have can capacity to clean our surroundings. Means in our home, we have one sweeper in our home, but these autonomous robots have a capacity to clean our earth, means to clean our homes. And also to serve a different types of autonomous robots are there. And also preparing the cook to a one person. And also to give any message to a one person who are taking and who are make the autonomous robots. These autonomous robots are very, very useful, and it cannot be depend on others. It can be only depend ourself only, and to do work in their surroundings only, and research and to kill the insects in her homes, and to make the curries and food to serve the people, and to give and everything will be in a home will be done by the only autonomous robots. And next, friends, we have a remote control robots. These remote control robots are very useful to us. Means we know that, friends, WW means World Wide Web. Means we are researching the information from different places. These remote control robots are very useful, and the time we research the different information about our world. These robots are very useful to us to gather the information from different countries in the world. And these remote control robots are used, it is the mediator of the users and a computer system. Means it can store the information to send that a computer to a user. This is about the remote control robots. Okay, friends, this is the Sophia robot. We can say this is a Chitti robot. And next, we have a lot of advantages about this robots. Yes or no, friends? Yes. What are they? We can see now. Advantages of the robots. Going to far away planets. And second is going far down into the unknown water and mines, where humans would be crushed. And third one is giving us information that humans cannot get, working at a places 24/7 without any salary and food. Plus, they do not get bored. And fourth one is that they can perform tasks faster than the humans and much more consistently and accurately. And the fifth one is that most of them are automatic, so they can go around by themselves without any human interference. Means, friends, okay, we know that. What is the advantages of robots? Yes or no? I am saying already, mobile robots. This robot have capacity to go there in a space and to research there different planet, what is going on there. In this way, these robots are used. And also, these robots are very, very useful to us to save the user's time. Yes or no? So, for example, we have a quickly to do work within the time. But we have capacity to do work, but within the time a robot can do work fastly and flexibly and easier way. The aim of robot is to create the world in a flexible way and a easier way to modify the world in this way. This is the aim of robots. These robots are very, very useful. And also these robots is like a machines. These machines are like a computer system. This computer system have capacity to do work. And also this computer system have a capacity to defeat the human beings, means in a play games and everything. Friends, a computer also can beat the human in a chess game. Okay friends, this is a lot of advantages about the robots. And we have also a disadvantages about the robots that are people can lose jobs in a factories. It needs a supply of power. It needs to maintenance to keep it running. It costs money to make or buy a robot. Means friends, we have a lot of advantages about the robots, yes or no? Yes, we have a more and more advantages about the robot. And also friends, we have a lot of disadvantages about the robot. That robot have a capacity to destroy and collapse the world. They have a capacity. But without the guidance of the human being, a robot have no capacity to do any work. That is the main thinking of computer, main thinking of computers and also a human beings. Friends, we know that by using these robots, we are feel guilty, yes or no? These robots are imitate the human beings, people. And we are feel unhappy, we are feel unemployment, we are getting unemployment, we are getting jobless. In future, we are once again remember in your future 2050, by using these robots, we are total our world people are unemployment by using these robots. Whenever these robots are to reverse to a people, that world will be collapsed by the robots. That is a very, very dangerous about the robot. Robot have a capacity to do work in a flexible way and easier way in the world to save a user time. But these robots have also a lot of disadvantages to destroy and collapse all over the world. And this is the disadvantages of computer. And also friends, these robots is a very useful in our future. That day is not far when you will just sit back in your cozy little beds and just command your personal robots to entirely do your roads. We will be a perfect companion for you. Just enjoy the technology. Means friends, by using these robots we are to get and enjoy the technology. Means by using these robots we are feel very happy. Means everyone have a capacity, people, but we have some limitations and we have a rules and regulations. So okay friends, but we are using this is also another thing. And but wait, do not be happy, it may end in other way too. Some days there will be a knock to your door. As you open it, you see a large number of robots marching into your house, destroying everything you are own and looting you. Friends, these robots are very, very useful to us in this generation. But in future, we are once again remember what is going on there. By using this lot of robots, but we face a little much of problems. We are getting unemployment. We are getting not possibly way to solve any problems. We are getting unbored. Means a robot have a capacity to do work in a 24 hours day and night. Means a robot is a artificial intelligence. A robot is a one type of artificial intelligence. But we have a different types of artificial intelligence. Modeling exactly how women actually act, modeling how ideal agents should think, modeling how ideal agents should act. These are the different types of artificial intelligence. But these AI have a one type of robot that is a very, very useful in our life. Friends, okay. Okay. But conclusion of these robots, it is a short extension. AI is an increased understanding of the nature of intelligence and provide an impressive array of application in a wide range areas. It has a sharpened understanding of human reasoning and of the nature of intelligence in a general. At the same time, it has revealed the complexity of modeling human reasoning, providing new areas and rich challenges for the future. This is about the future, friends. Okay, friends, we know what is the going on the world. By using these robots, friends, it is a very, very useful. And also, we personally use these robots. But some robots have a capacity. But conclusion of this topic, artificial intelligence is not correctly intelligence. It will be manipulate task to rotate herself to without the guidance of human beings. A robot have a no capacity and AI have a no capacity to do any work in the earth. This AI can understand to voice recognition and everything, but this AI have a similar task is there. And also, friends, in our daily life, we can lot of intelligence systems we can use in a post office, bank, telephone companies, computer companies, Netflix, and etc. Okay, friends, these intelligence system we can use in a post office by sorting the mails, and telephone companies means to recognize the voice of people. And we can use it in a Google technology, Netflix, move recommendation. This is the total about the intelligence we can use in our more and more in our daily life. These friends, these robots are very, very useful. These robots are do anything, but some robots have emotions and feelings. But some robots have a no capacity to express their any emotions and feelings. So very, very thankful to listen this topic. So this class is a broad introduction about the what is artificial intelligence. This is a nothing but a machine. It is a branch of computer science. Okay, friends, today our subject mentor is a B. Supriya madam. I heartfully thankful to you, madam. And also my principal M. Hanuman sir, I heartfully to given this golden opportunity to me. Both are and every madam can encourage me to move in a they can push in me in forward direction. Heartfully thankful, sir. Once again, remember our beloved dynamic secretary Dr. R.S. Praveen Kumar sir to provide this golden opportunity to me. Thanking you, sir. Thanking you.